name is Benjamin Wickham. I'm a specialist in the U.S. Army Caisson Platoon. I'm a military horseman. Since my arrival here to the Caisson section in August of 2021, I've loved this job more than anything I've ever done. And I appreciate all the work that goes into it and the historical significance of it, as well as the level of honors and the importance of providing this service to these families. And I'd love to do this job for as long as I can, as long as the Army will let me.
This is Block and McCall, the 2 3-year-old pure Percheron.
Probably the best part of the job is just getting to wake up every morning and come and work with these amazing animals that I've got to build a relationship with over the past couple of years. I work with a great group of guys. Like, I learn something new every day. And training horses is unlike anything else I've ever done. It's a lot of nonverbal communication, a lot of breeding the animal, and getting to build that relationship with the animals and work with them every day is super fulfilling. So for a lot of events, there's a lot of noises and sounds these horses aren't used to. The horses don't encounter in their natural habitat. Horses can get very flighty. They're naturally scared of everything. So the biggest tool that we use to prepare situations like that is desensitization. So we'll expose them to noises and sounds that they're unsure of, that at first are going to freak them out, that are going to scare them. And then we teach them that it's okay. Like, for example, in a parade, there's going to be flags up and down. There's going to be people throwing candy, flowers through the air, and they're not used to that. Their natural habitat is going to be out here in a pasture like this. And so we'll do everything we can to replicate that here at the barn, to teach them that it's okay, that they're going to be safe, that whenever a kid lets off a little popper streamers, that it's not going to hurt them. So the more we can get them used to things they're unsure of, the better it'll be and the calmer they'll be able to stay during an event or a situation like that. There's nothing like getting them over a fear or teaching them something new and like recognizing that bond. And that's really important. That's a great like day-to-day thing, but another thing that really solidifies what makes this job as important as it is the service that we're providing for these families. We do our best every single funeral to make sure that everything is as perfect as it could be. One of the most important things to remind ourselves of and keep in practice is that this family only gets one funeral. We need to make sure that every single time we are out there mounted in that cemetery, that we're giving it our absolute best. That our horses are their best, our uniforms look the best, and that we're doing the exact same ceremony as good as we can every single time. It's fulfilling to provide them with that one last measure of honors. Well, working with animals of this size, there's always an inherent risk. Being around anything with a mind of its own, it's upwards of 1,500 pounds, as most of our horses are. I've encountered a decent amount of injuries myself. You're going to get stepped on. You're going to get kicked from time to time. It's not a common occurrence, but it does happen. I've been kicked in the hand, broken a couple fingers. I've been bucked off while doing training. Sometimes you have to put these horses into situations that they're not comfortable with. It's part of training. It's part of getting them used to it. And sometimes you do get hurt. It's not fun, but it's a part of the job that we're all used to. And you have to come back from. It's not the animal's fault. They're never trying to be malicious, but you have to just have to roll with it, and you still love these animals just as much, no matter what happens. Stop. So here it's only the six or seven of us, our horse trainer, our head trainer, and our herd manager. So if anything happens to these horses, we do have a vet that's on call, but they're not always able to come out here. So most of the time we take care of injuries and bite and scrapes for the most part by ourselves. We've all been trained. Our training is pretty extensive when it comes to the biology of a horse and what signs to look for if they're sick or if they're feeling unwell. Every other week we do a full body checkup pretty much on all the horses, and we'll take their temperatures, their pulse, check the respiratory rates, check them all over, do a full body scan for any injuries or swelling. Most of the medical care that's provided for these horses we do by ourselves, and we're all trained for it, and it's a great tool that we have to be able to keep an eye on these, because we're around these horses more than anybody else, and it's great that we have the knowledge and the drive to keep these horses as healthy as possible. As much of my job is spent out here in the pastures and in the saddle, a lot of time goes into prepping our uniforms to look right for an event. For an event, we need to make sure our uniforms are dry cleaned, need to make sure that our uniforms are pressed, need to make sure that all of our ribbon racks and pins are all measured out correctly. Need to make sure there's no loose strings hanging off the uniform, burn those off, make sure our ceremonial caps are straight, don't have any fingerprints or anything on them. What takes the most time is polishing up our boots. For every funeral, I'll spend between 3 and 4 hours polishing my boots, making sure that they're in tip-top shape. If I'm completely stripping and repolishing the boots, it's about a 6-7 hour job to get them looking absolutely perfect, the way I want them to be. I was raised in the southwest side of Dallas County in the city of Irving. My parents growing up were always very supportive and very patriotic. They're proud of where we're from and what this country stands for, and have raised me to believe the same. And so I'm not too surprised, and they were extremely proud for me to join the military and to serve our country like this. And they're even more proud of the job that I'm doing now. They are very supportive of everything that I've done in my career so far, and I'm looking forward to doing in the future. Like last Tuesday, whenever we had our dedication ceremony for our two new horses, Block and McCall, my father was able to come down and attend. And it's really meaningful to have them there supporting me in person and getting to see what I do. It's really cool. We're currently the only active Caisson platoon in the entire U.S. Army. And it's really cool to be a part of that, because it's the highest level of military honors that you can receive as a service member. And getting a chance to work with horses all day and to train horses and absorb all this equestrian knowledge has been awesome. I couldn't wait to be a part of that. And it's also equally as meaningful to get to provide this service to the families of our fallen service members. Outside of work, I'm pretty active. I love rock climbing. Ride and train horses outside of work as well. It's kind of a hobby. Me and some of the other guys are also involved in the local rodeos a little bit. Bull riding in our off time is one of the favorite things to do. If I could stick with a Caisson platoon for my whole career, I would. I'm going to try to extend here at the end of my contract and continue to be a member of the Caisson section here at Fort Sam Houston. But at some point I'll come down on orders to send me somewhere else, but I'm going to try to fight to get back after that contract to get back here.
Did you know when you were joining the Army, this is what you're going
to be? No, I had no clue. Especially enlisting as an infantryman, I was not expecting anything like this at all. But it's been very lucky. I had no way I've been doing that.
It's been a huge honor, and that's something that I know I'll look back on and be proud of forever.